Please subscribe to my channel Think Deep and hit the bell icon for more updates.
My friends, last month, if you clearly remember, there was a major controversy between two Bollywood films. One was Ujra Chaman and one was Bala. Both these films deal with one topic, which is premature balding. So there was a lot of speculation, rumors and controversy that, you know, Ujra Chaman has the same storyline as Bala and vice versa. So finally, Ujra Chaman released last week and unfortunately did not do well in the box office. So now all the anticipation and speculations were on Bala, whether Bala will break the box office records or will do better than Ujra Chaman, or whether it has the same storyline. So finally, Bala has released. And I have lots to talk about the film.
और सांड का वीर्य मिला के अपने सर पर लगा लेना।
बालक, तुझे हूर जैसी परी मिलेगी।
हमने नहीं करनी शादी वादी।
जितना विकेट विकेट।
My friends, this is Deep Basu and welcome to my channel Think Deep. And today I'm going to review the most awaited film and controversial film, Bala, a Bala, a Bala.
कहीं जगह है।
कर्ली टाइम घुंघरालू होंगे।
हां, मलिंगा का चल्ला आजकल भैया,
छांट के बाल सर पे लगाने को बोल रहा है आदमी, हम नहीं करवाएंगे।
सो फ्रेंड्स, इफ यू हैव सीन द ट्रेलर वेरी क्लोजली, बाला डस टॉक अबाउट द कॉन्सेप्ट प्री मैच्योर बॉल्डिंग एंड हाउ अ यंग गाय फेसेस प्री मैच्योर बॉल्डिंग एंड हिज जर्नी, द ऑब्स्टिकल ही फेसेस एंड मोरलिस्टली द प्लॉट इज प्रीटी सिमिलर टू उज्जा चमन, बट ट्रस्ट मी, बाला इज इन कंपैरिजन अ फार फार सुपीरियर फिल्म इन टर्म्स ऑफ स्क्रिप्ट, इन टर्म्स ऑफ परफॉर्मेंस, इन टर्म्स ऑफ एग्जीक्यूशन। So the story of Bala is very simple. It takes us back to 2005 and introduces us to a 15-year-old Balmukund Shukla who has strong hair, good looks. He gets a lot of female attention. He's a Shah Rukh Khan of the entire school and his classroom. He's a total hero. Females love him. Everyone loves him actually. And he's so proud of his looks that he looks down upon his classmate and neighbor called Latika, who is dark-skinned and not so good-looking. So the first few minutes into the film, we are introduced to the childhood days of Balmukund Shukla. Then after a few sequences, cut to story now takes us 11 years ahead in the year 2016, where Balmukund Shukla, as known as Bala, is a 25-year-old boy and is suffering from extreme premature balding. He works in the marketing team of a Ferris product. Bala tries a lot of techniques to grow his hair, but nothing works. Hair transplant is an option, but he can't opt for as he is diabetic. With no other option in his hand, Bala accepts his father's suggestion and opts for a wig. He is then sent to Lucknow, where his company is shooting for an ad with Pari Mishra. She's a popular TikTok star and Bala has a major crush on her. He meets her during the course of the shoot and woos her. In no time, both fall in love and begin a romantic relationship. Realizing that things are getting serious between them, Bala feels he should tell Pari that he's bald and he wears a wig. However, he's not able to, especially when he realizes that for Pari, external beauty matters the most. He fears that if he confesses to Pari, she'll dump him. Their respective families meet and the marriage is fixed. What happens next forms the rest of the story. The original story of Bala has been written by Pavin Bhattacharya, who is a Bengali filmmaker. And after that, Niren Bhatt has crafted it and made it into a Bollywood film. The story is very simple, very straightforward. But the dialogues of Niren Bhatt is something which stands out. Like, you know, when I take my selfie, I have self-pity. So just like Scream, the dialogues of Bala really stands out and keeps the movie flowing. The first half of the film is fun and entertaining, so definitely that will keep you hooked. The second half becomes a little serious, though it's fun and entertaining also. The second half explores topics about self-love and how a person should accept himself the way he is and should not be succumbed to society pressure. It also clearly talks about accepting oneself despite all various imperfections. Director Amar Kaushik has done a swell job. If you have seen his first film, Stree, you will get to know he's a talented director. He knows his characters, he knows his topic. And I love the flow he has maintained. He has kept a proper balance between entertainment and seriousness. The only complaint I have that, you know, a few characters are slightly underwhelming and not very well etched out. Well, the character of Seema Pawar, the character of Javed Jafri, all few characters are not very well etched out. They are somewhat wasted in the film. Though Javed Jafri has done a great role, even Seema Pawar has done her role pretty fairly. But somehow I feel that some few of the characters are not very well explored or etched out. The entire film belongs to Ayushmann Khurrana. The entire story revolves around Ayushmann Khurrana. Well, if you talk about the performances, it's an on and out Ayushmann Khurrana's film. Ayushmann Khurrana has slept through this role. And I don't think it was a big challenge for Ayushmann Khurrana, apart from the good makeup, apart from the challenging makeup. I don't think it was a big challenge for Ayushmann Khurrana to essay this role. These kind of characters, I feel Ayushmann Khurrana has played before, so I don't think playing and essaying this character was a big challenge for Ayushmann Khurrana. And by the way, Ayushmann Khurrana is having a dream run at the box office. He has given 6 hits in a row. Can you imagine? Last time, I believe Akshay Kumar was the one actor who gave 5 hits in one row. Ayushmann Khurrana, I think, is the third actor. I think Rajesh Khanna was first, second was Akshay Kumar, third was Ayushmann Khurrana giving 6 hits in a row. So Ayushmann Khurrana has done a great job, but I don't think it was quite challenging for him. Yami and Bhumi have done a great role. Respectively, they have done justice to their respective characters. And I was very surprised to see Yami Gautam. She was superb in a character, Pari Mishra. Ayushmann's brother, played by Dhirendra Gautam, is a revelation. And definitely a must-watch. You need to watch this actor. He has done a great job, Dhirendra Gautam. And other characters, all of them, even Saurav Shukla, Seema Pava, as I told you, all of them have respectively done a fair job. So overall, the film Bala delivers a good message, a very meaningful message. But somehow, I feel the film lacks the impact. After watching the film, you will feel that, you know, the message has weightage. But somehow, I felt it lacked impact. Means I didn't get quite emotional watching the film. Like, there are a few films you do get emotional, you do get teary-eyed, but Bala didn't give me that feel. I didn't get that impact. But in spite of that, Bala has a meaningful message at the end. You need to watch it to find out. Music by Sachin Jigar is, I think, the minus point of the film. Sachin Jigar are brilliant music composers, if you have seen their previous work. But somehow, surprisingly, the music of Bala doesn't stand out. I feel the music could have been better. Apart from the performances, the second thing which stands out in the film is the editing. The editor, Hemanti Sarkar, has done a great job. The film looks sleek and unhurried, and definitely it has maintained a good duration. It's not very long or dragged towards the end. And lastly, let me forget, Vijay Ras is the narrator of the film. He's the sutradhar of the film. And definitely, he's an icing of the cake. He basically is the hair. Yeah, and he's telling this entire story and taking us to the journey of Bala. So definitely Vijay Ras's voiceover is the icing on the cake. So you need to watch this film to find out more. On the whole, Bala is not only an entertaining film, it also delivers a serious message. It talks about self-love, how a person should love him or herself in spite of the imperfections. So Bala is a must-watch, and I rest my case. As a film, Bala is indeed far superior from Ujra Chamma. So Bala is a must-watch. So hats off to the team, Amar Kaushik, the writer Niren Bhatt, and of course, salute to Pavay Bhattacharya for a wonderful story. But personally, I didn't feel this film to be that emotionally impactful. But nevertheless, it's a nice film. You should go and watch it. So friends, I finally sign off. If you have not watched Bala, watch it and share your views in the comment box below. If you agree to my content, let me know. If you don't agree few points, let me know in the comments box below. And if you want to get in touch with me, you can get in touch with me on Instagram. My handle is Deep Basu. On Twitter, my handle is Deep Basu 1. And of course, on YouTube, my handle is Think Deep Basu. Please, please, please subscribe to my channel if you love my content. I'll get back once again with more updates on Bollywood, cinema, and more film reviews. And frankly speaking, I won't be watching Satellite Shankar or The Wrong Turn by Nilendra Mukesh. So if you watch the movie, please share your views and reviews. So for now, goodbye and watch Bala. Bye.